Hi children, good morning. This is video number 20 from the chapter Current Electricity. The last concept of this chapter, video number 20 of chapter Current Electricity, and I am going to discuss potentiometer, its applications. In the video number 19, I have uploaded the first application of potentiometer. This is second application, which is to determine the internal resistance of a cell. As I told you, the circuit diagram for the primary path will be common in all the applications. So the primary circuit will be the battery, the rheostat. The same arrangement you will see in practicals also. In the practicals also we have the same arrangement, but some books they draw in a complex way, like they want to show that potentiometer wire is having 10 meter length. So they draw the wire like this. Ding, 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 ding. They draw the wire like this. Not necessary. You can show it as a single line. Like this I can show. Right? A to B. Here what they do? They take this as A and this as B. And they show it as number of turns like this. Like this. Number of rows. I told you number of rows like this. 1, 2, 3, 1. Like this again. That's what they show. I don't think it is correct. It is required. Okay. You can easily understand the length of the potentiometer even if it is tried also. There is no issue. This portion is common in all the circuit. You can have an ammeter. Now, in the secondary circuit, we have a cell of EMFP, internal resistance is smaller, connected to a galvanometer and then to jockey. This will give you the balance signal. Parallel to it, we connect a resistance capital R and we have a key here, which is K1. This is a circuit diagram to determine the internal resistance of a cell. Now, it has got two parts. First, we open the key K1. K1 is open. When K1 is open, no current flows through the circuit here. No current flows through it. That means cell E is in the open circuit. When the cell is in the open circuit, according to the principle of potentiometer, measure the balancing length, which is equal to L1. EMF of the cell is balanced against L1 length of the potentiometer. There won't be any drop across this internal resistance because galvanometer is showing null reflection. That means zero current flows through it. Zero current flows through it. So no drop across the internal resistance. Thank you. K1 is closed. When you close this, this part of the circuit is closed. There will be some drop across this small resistance, internal resistance smaller. Whatever be the potential difference across this, same will be the potential difference across this, which is balanced by L2 of the potentiometer. Because now the current flows through the cell, that current is something else, not the primary current. And this potential difference V across the cell is equal to potential difference across the external resistance capital R, that is balanced against L2 length of the potentiometer wire. That means here I should not take E. Here I should take B. Now it is clear. What is E? E is the EMF of the cell. What is V? V is the potential difference between the two terminals of the cell when the cell is driving current. Here cell is driving current.
When the cell is not driving current, how come we expect a potential difference across capital R?
So, I hope it is clear. Here, cell is driving current. Cell is driving current. That's why there is some potential difference across this capital R. So, in the second case, when E KL is closed, I cannot take E equal to KL2. Moreover, I have to take V equal to KL2. What is K here? Remember, what is K here? K is the potential gradient. What is K here? K is the potential gradient.
Now we go for the next part of the derivation. Okay, let us see.
Equation 1 by equation 2. I get E by V is equal to KL1 by KL2. Cancel K. I get L1 by L2, which is equation number 3. While discussing the concept of terminal potential difference, I have given you some formulas. We know that E by V equal to R plus R by R, R1 plus R by R. If you remember, then it is okay. Otherwise, go back to the previous videos and learn this concept. E by V equal to R plus R by capital R, which is equal to 1 plus small r by capital R.
So,
E by V can be written as 1 plus small r by capital R, equation number 4. From equations 3 and 4, third equation says E by V as L1 by L2. Fourth equation says E by V as 1 plus small r by capital R. 1 plus small r by capital R is equal to L1 by L2. Small r by capital R is equal to L1 by L2 minus 1, which is L1 minus L2 by L2. Therefore, small r equal to capital R into L1 minus L2 by L2. This is the internal resistance of a cell.
Children, I hope you have understood this. So, in this application, what we have to do, first the potentiometer applications. First we have to draw the circuit diagram, and then we have to draw the circuit diagram. In the secondary circuit, there is something different when compared with the previous circuit. And then we have to go to this derivation. When K1 is open, then it will be E equal to KL1. When K1 is closed, V equal to KL2. Then divide 1 by 2, you will get E by V as L1 by L2. We know that E by V equal to 1 plus small r, E by V equal to R plus R by R, which is equal to 1 plus small r by capital R. So E by V equal to 1 plus small r by capital R, equation 4. From 3 and 4 equations, I can write 1 plus small r by capital R L1 by L2. From there, I will get the expression small r equal to R into L1 minus L2 by L2. So with this, I have finished the theory part of this chapter with 20 videos. Thank you, children. Thank you very much.